And RJ, are there also opportunities for financing here, especially those who lack capital?
Yes, so we work with several banks and small rural banks who want to be able to loan money to future franchisees as well. But at the same time, like we said, we're making things bite-sized for those who don't have a large budget to invest in franchises. We're actually making it a bit smaller for them to invest here. We often tell people, and I think it's very important for us to say this one, that if you're going to invest in a franchise business, the money which you usually use for the franchise should not come from, should come from your excess income or for your, for what you've saved also. You're okay with your regular income over here, but if you have something extra on the side that you think you can invest in, this is what you use for your franchising business. Why franchising is great here in the Philippines, there's a 90% success rate because many established franchises have already gone through the trial and error. So by the time they franchise the business to you, there's already an operating system which they give to you, the franchisee. But in any business, there is still a bit of a risk. So we're always saying, telling people that if you invest, don't invest something that you that you need for day-to-day spending, but rather it's something that you have saved maybe for the rainy day or some extra money that you have that you think can, you can grow further.
Okay, RJ, you've been doing this advocacy for quite some time now, and through all of those decades, you're always in search for the next big thing when it comes to business ideas. Might you share with us how you envision the next big thing would be?
Okay, we got winners of our recent a recent competition, which is the Franchise Incubation Contest. In this one, the first winner was Green Earth. Really great concept. Out of Bicol, it was a concept that, that they had really great vegetarian food, which is going, we think is going to grow very, very fast. The second one is called Cacao Culture. This is out of Davao. And it's both a social advocacy and an entrepreneurial program where they want to expand the idea of, you know, using Filipino chocolate both as a drink and in the recipes to grow further. And we want to support that one. We think it's going to be a, the next big franchise as well. And the third one is called Dirtbag. Dirtbag is an app which you can actually use for your laundry services. All you have to do is, let's say you got laundry, you just have to go on the app. It will pick up the items from your house, wash it, and deliver it back to your house, all by just using an app. So they've simplified, or they'd rather solve the pain point of you having to wash your clothes and going through an arduous process of going out and having it laundered. And the fourth one is called All Food. All Food is a healthy food business which uses vending machines to be able to sell their products. So those are the next big concepts we have, which won the Franchise Incubation Contest. But aside from that one, the next, the up-and-coming franchise awardees included a company called Churreros, which Churreros. Is the CDO. Really great churros, which came out. Another one is called Popad. Do you know, Stan, how many people bought pets during the pandemic? So the pet stores and all these different pet food owners, pet hotels increased in business. So the Popad, which is a paw grooming salon, is growing very, very fast here as well. And the last one I think that's also growing very fast as well is another business. It is called... Oh, it escapes the top of my mind here right now, but one is very fast. It's a digital innovator award. Sarisuki that works together with Sarisuki just won. Was just mentioned in the Forbes Top 100 Startups to Look Out For here in the Philippines. They're developing mini Suki franchises so people can have become a franchisor, a franchisee rather, out of their own homes.
All right, RJ. Lastly, you know, capital and resources, they're easy to find as there's always help, even from your group. Now, I think the biggest enemy here would be fear of the unknown when it comes to risking and getting into business. Now, RJ, what's the best argument that you have to win those who are afraid to your side?
Okay, I think the most important thing to realize is that for many entrepreneurs, and Stan, I'm sure you're familiar with it yourself, no? That it's, you know, failure, you have either the failure or the growth mindset. And the idea is that sometimes the businesses don't always do good, right? But the point is that you are learning from every point of that experience. For many franchise businesses, they have already failed. They've had some failures in the past, right? And what they did is they developed an operating manual which has taken into consideration all the best practices, all the failures that they've had, and corrected them. And that's what they are marketing to you. So if you're going to get into franchising business, what you're assured of is that instead of starting a business from scratch where you don't know anything, the great thing about franchising is that there's already a manual ready for you. There are operating systems ready for you. So it's almost like an MBA in running a business which they are giving to you. Just make sure that when you're choosing a franchisor or somebody who wants a franchise, that they are somebody who has a strong track record and are willing to work with you, are transparent with you in wanting to grow the business. Like for me, one of the best partners we've had here so far, grown together their business, is Mr. Donut, growing very, very quickly over here. Stan, if you want one franchise of Mr. Donut, let me know. We'd love to help you out.
I'll think about it. RJ Ledesma, we hope Franchise Day would push more Filipinos to explore entrepreneurship and its immeasurable rewards. Thank you so much again and have a good day.
Thank you, Stan.